Hey, it's Ken from Exploring the Simulation. So I decided to make an Android phone with a lightning connector. Whoa. Now you're probably thinking, why? I know it makes absolutely no sense to do this. After making the first USB-C iPhone, some people suggested I do the opposite. So okay, sure, for fun and as a challenge. And I thought it would be a pretty good idea to post it on April 1st so that people wouldn't get too mad about it. Now I know there's iPhone clones out there running Android that were designed from the get-go to have a lightning port. Those were made by big teams of Chinese engineers, but can a single person like me downgrade their Samsung phone to have a lightning port? Well, yes, and here's how. So I got all those comments saying I should do this, but I knew right away it would be very difficult. The reason is that usually those cables have a few protections. The first one is electrical. I mean, the cable only outputs power if it is properly plugged in. Otherwise, you would get short circuits all the time. But here it also goes a bit further. Apple wants to protect the whole lightning ecosystem. So when a cable is plugged in, it talks to the iPhone and each side verifies that they are a certified Apple product. Now the problem comes when I want to plug the cable into an Android phone. The cable will send some requests, but it won't hear anything back. There needs to be something in between, a honeypot? And that's big problem number one. Do I crack this verification? Surely someone has already done the heavy lifting for me. You know they build fake iPhone cables in China, right? Well, that means there is fake iPhone cable factories somewhere in the simulation. And those factories need a way to test those cables, right? Well, turns out they don't really use an iPhone for this. So a very niche company created this board right here, whose whole purpose is to test lightning cables. Maybe there is a chip on this board that does exactly what I need. Let's investigate. You plug in your cable on one side, and on the other side, you can have any USB powered load. What stops me from plugging in an Android phone on this side? Nothing. Boom. Does data work though? Doesn't look like it, but my intuition tells me that maybe it could. On the back side, I see that they ran traces for a USB 2.0 signal. I need to understand this board better. So I remove all the components and I create a schematic of all the connections. I see that the data traces I just showed you are connected to two pins on the lightning connector. I remove the connector because the traces are hidden underneath, and then I cut off the extra connections using a scalpel. Now the traces are only connected to the right pin and I soldered the connector back on top. Let's try USB again. Yes, it works. So now the electronics work. It's just a game of microengineering, making the whole thing fit inside of the phone. Let's see what we're working with. I disassembled the Samsung Galaxy A51 I'm working with. I think I'll see pretty quickly if I have enough room or not. Ouch, the USB-C connector is absolutely tiny. Look at the size of the lightning connector next to it. No way it's going to fit because it's limited by the cutout in the board. Okay, major letdown. I need to think. Whoa, something crazy happened. I was working on another project and I was disassembling this thing right here. It's a lightning charging and headphone splitter. And while I was disassembling it, it's the first time I see such a tiny lightning connector. I mean, everywhere I looked, it was the same size as what I already showed you. But this one, well, this one is very small, but still not small enough. Interestingly, if I pull on it, we can see that it is made out of two pieces. The first one holding the pins, and the second one is just a frame for the pins. Now I can try sending this piece down, but it's not going to be great. It's too small. Luckily, I recently got my hands on a resin 3D printer, which allows to print super tiny details. Could I make my own custom connector so that it fits inside the phone? You bet. First thing first, I need to recreate the original piece to see if my measurements have the right tolerances. Once that's done, I can start modifying the shape to keep its main function, but shave off as much volume as I possibly can. I went through maybe 6 or 7 iterations, and at the end I finally got exactly what I needed. Now, I didn't want to create a custom PCB for this project as nobody will ever use it. So I activate my steady hands mode and get started with soldering the whole circuit by hand with small wires. It took maybe an hour or two. I know this pretty little girl is not thinking about me. I know I'll never be able to swim with her in the sea. My dreams for her are just unknown. The trips I make are on my own. But maybe she thinks the same about me. But pretty little girls like her, trust me, they know exactly that they attract to men with their super strong gravity. The thoughts I have are fantasies. I'll never calm my anxiety if I don't make it reality. I had to make some extra room, so I sanded some plastic down with a Dremel. So I closed the phone and the project was done. It worked! Now, it was a super fun technical challenge and I'm relieved that most of you understood it was kind of a joke for April Fool's Day. I'm back to doing serious projects now and you can expect new content very soon. If you have any other suggestions, let them know in the comment section below. Stay tuned! Peace! Yeah.